So what's your name?
My name is Pao and I'm 17 years old.
Okay, so welcome to the IELTS mock test. Okay, so in the test, we will have three parts. Okay, let's get started with part one.
Okay.
In part one, I would like to ask you some personal questions. Okay.
Okay.
So let's talk about money. Okay. So when you go shopping, do you prefer to pay for things in cash or by card?
I would like to pay everything in by cash.
Why?
Because when I use cards, I need to remember the password for the cards, and I am really good at memorizing everything. So I would like to bring my cash, and also when I bring my cash, I also can show everybody that I have a lot of cash. So I can show that I have a lot of cash, I am rich, and everybody will
love you.
Yeah, kind of love me for that.
Okay, you're too funny, but that's good. That's okay. Do you ever save money to buy special things?
I have saved money to buy special things like this phone.
Mm-hmm.
This phone right here. I started saving money like in 3 or 4 months before I bought this.
Mm-hmm.
With 3.9 million.
Wow.
Kind of a lot. And my first phone that I bought with my own saved money, so I really love my phone. And
okay, so would you ever take a job which had low pay?
I would like to take a job with a higher pay, but if the job gave me experience, or job can help me improve my own self, so I would like to also choose a job with low pay. Although it has a low pay, but it will help me gain experience to have higher paid job.
Okay. So would winning a lot of money make a big difference to your life?
Yes, winning a big money really made a big change in my life. As you know, my life has been it has been really, I don't know what to say, but my life without money is really hard. I can't do much thing without money, and money can place a very important place in our life. Without money, we cannot do much thing. Especially when I'm young like this, I can't do much things.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that is the end of part one. Now let's move on to part two. In part two, we provided a cue card. Okay. It contains some information about the topic. Okay. And you have 2 minutes to talk about the topic.
Okay.
But before you talk, you will have 1 minute to think about what you are going to say. And I'm going to give you a pen. Blank sheet of paper so you can take notes if you wish. Okay, so 1 minute of preparation starts. preparation time is over. Okay. Now you have 2 minutes to talk about the topic. 2 minutes.
Okay. The my last my an interesting discussion I had as a part of my work of study was to make a research and show the differences between I still don't have any concept. Still too tired.
So you can remember about a discussion with your friends that you had in the past. Okay? What's the topic of the discussion?
I would not really pay attention on any subject in my class except English.
I mean, it's not like the subject that you have at school, like the talk in real life out of the school, out of the classrooms. It can be, you know, about the games, it can be about the future job, about the, it can be about the hobbies. So in part 3, I'll be asking you more questions that are related to part 2, okay?
Okay.
The first one, let's talk about discussing problems with others, okay?
Okay.
So why is it good to discuss problems with other people?
It is good to discuss problems with other people because sometimes you don't have the real way or the real solutions to solve the problem. You need others. You need the other help so that you can have the better way to solve your problem, and sometimes you can find an easier way, or you can make a comparison between two solution, and from that you can choose an easier way easier solution so that you can solve the problem easier.
So do you think that it's better to talk to friends and not family about problems?
Yeah, I think it's easier to talk the problems with my friends or not with my family, because friends are the people that are really close to me, not close to my family, but they can be a good listener. Sometimes when you talk your problem with your family, they will care about you, but sometimes they will just think that it is a normal problem in life that they have faced. Not like your friends. Their friends, all the friends are the same age as you, so when you talk a problem to your friend, they will understand, they more understand than your family.
So is it always a good idea to tell lots of people about a problem?
No, it's not a good idea to tell your problem with lots of people, because sometimes when you want to hear some solutions, you cannot just ask many persons with the same problems. It will make you feel unconscious between lots and lots of solutions.
Okay, let's talk about the communication skills at work. Okay, so which communication skills are most important when taking part in meetings with colleagues?
Oh, that's a really good question. The most useful skill in communication may be the skill to brainstorming or the skill to critical thinking, I think. That makes you think about more and more of ideas and things to talk to, not just sticking to one topic, is kind of make the conversation boring.
Mm-hmm. So So what are the possible effects of poor written communication skills at work?
There are lots of drawbacks of poor communication skill in
written communication skill.
Written?
Yeah.
Poor written communication skill can lead to a lot of things. Sometimes you cannot. Sometimes when some device like your phone or your computer are not working, you need to write letters to your family. They are far away, or your friends, they are far away. You don't have the skill of writing. You cannot express what you feel or express what is happening around you, and they will not really understand what you're kind of talking about. Mm-hmm.
And the last question. What do you think will be the future impact of technology on communication in the workplace?
Technology.
So what do you think will be the future impact of technology, okay, on communication in the workplace?
Okay, as you know, the technologies these days are increasing. And they are getting more and more written, so the way we communicate with others are faster, better, with the sound quality or the camera quality. You can communicate with friends around the world, you can communicate with friends just around your neighborhood with a faster way, or maybe you don't have Wi-Fi, you can use 4G, like data. Like mobile data, and not like before when you want to communicate with your friends. Number one is to writing letters, or number two, you can use the phone, but that costs you a lot of money.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. That is the end of the test today. Thank you. You can invite Long.